This is Jason Gabriel with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and I wanted to do a video of operation and maintenance on our hammer mills. This is a 16 inch by 12 inch hammer mill, and it's rated at between 1 and 2 tons an hour, depending on the screen size that you put in the bottom. It's powered with a 15 horsepower three-phase motor, and it can be run both dual voltage at 60 hertz and dual voltage at 50 hertz for some of our international customers. Baldor also makes a 15 horsepower single phase motor that we've put on these machines as well for when three phase power is not available. We send the units with fully enclosed OSHA approved belt guards, and we have a variety of hoppers that we can put on here. This customer is going to be feeding with a small conveyor. It should be noted the rotation of the hammers and the shaft in the hammer mill. So as the material is fed down into the mill, it gets thrown back against the case and crushed against the case, rather than if it's spinning the wrong way, it'll go right into the screen and will wear out the screen much faster. It's important to have a fairly consistent feed rate with this mill, either shoveling or metering in with a bucket or a meter with a conveyor. The other thing with overfeeding is if you start to see material, water, and crushed material coming out the holes between the shaft and the case, reduce the rate of feed, because that material gets in the bearings, it'll wear the bearings out. It's recommended to run this mill wet with water. It takes about 1 to 2 US gallons per minute. Here's a little discharge chute coming out the bottom. This is reversible, so it can be bolted on to this side as well. Here's a look down the inside of this hammer mill. There are 4 rows of 5 hammers in this version, so there's 20 hammers total. You can see our laser cut screen down the bottom here. That's a 0.8 millimeter slot. It'll produce material that's 100% passing a 20 mesh and 50 to 60% passing a 50 mesh screen. These hammers are high chrome content, so they'll last depending on the material, if you're running abrasive quartz, they'll last somewhere between 1 to 2 weeks. They are reversible, so you can switch them around once this face is worn out. To change the hammers, you pull out the cotter pin. This pin slides out right over the bearing. You can turn the hammers around and then replace the pin. These screens are welded in to replace the screen. There's a weld along here, skip weld in 1, 2, 3 places. You just grind that out with a grinder, roll the new screen in, and weld it up, and you should be good to go. It takes about half an hour to do. It needs to be done about every 1 to 200 tons. This mill has replaceable armor all around the bottom. Bolt through to the outside of the case. To change the armor, you take out the bolts and knock that armor out, and then replace it with new stuff and bolt it back in. Here's a look up into the hood. Same thing, we have armor all the way around, top and bottom and sides. It's real easy to replace. You just take the bolts out, replace it with new armor, and bolt it right back in. This machine needs to be greased here and here once a day, a couple pumps of grease in there to keep the bearings working properly. Those are the only 2 grease fittings on this machine. Other things to check are the belts. Take the cover off every once in a while and check the belts for tightness. Using this jacking bolt here, the belt tension can be adjusted, so you loosen the motor mounting bolts, adjust the tension with this jacking screw here, and this one back here. get the bells tight, and then retighten your motor mounting bolts. When you first get the machine, run it for a couple hours and then shut down and check the tightness of all the bolts and the belts. The belts will stretch a little bit the first couple hours of operation, and some of the bolts may need to be tightened up again as well. We use Nylock nuts, so they shouldn't come loose, but it's always better to check after the first couple hours and make sure everything's still tight. Here are a couple different size screens that we use for the 16 by 12 inch hammer mill. This is a laser cut 0.8 millimeter screen, like you saw installed in the mill. This is great for miners because it produces a nice fine grind. This is the next size up we use. This is about a 1.2 or 1.3 millimeters. And this screen is also good for miners. It produces a little bit coarser grind. The throughput is increased, so this screen will do about 2,500 pounds an hour. And then we have an even larger screen here. This is between 2 and 3 millimeters. It doesn't grind as fine, but you get upwards of 2 tons an hour out of this size screen. We've sold this coarser size screen to guys who are regrinding metallic slag. And some of the soil additive guys like a little bit coarser grind, some of the fertilizer guys and things like that. So we found some good application for some of these coarser screens. Thanks for watching. And if you have any questions for us about our hammer mills, you can give us a call or email us, all which is in the description below. I'm interested to hear what you guys think of the mills. So give us a call or email us, and we'll catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.